Is GTA 4 Remaster coming very soon? New rumors about Beyond Good and Evil 2 and Rainbow Six Extraction price has been reduced. Hey, what's up guys, welcome back to GamerConnect, and you guys are watching top gaming news of this very week. So without any further ado, let's jump into some of those. With GTA Trilogy Remaster being criticized heavily by everybody, Rockstar Games' parent company Take-Two Interactive have decided to take down more GTA mods with their DMCA strikes. This time around, these mods are of GTA 4, and Take-Two have taken 3 mods related to GTA 4. Over the last year, Take-Two removed some mods as well as sued fan devs over source code projects. These takedowns happened for older games such as Vice City or GTA 3, and soon after that, Rockstar announced that there is going to be a definitive edition coming soon. So because of this, a lot of people are speculating that it could be possible that GTA 4 Remaster might be coming up next, because Take-Two is doing the exact same activity by removing all the mods that is made by the modders. So it could be possible that by next year maybe, or maybe by the end of this year, we'll get GTA 4 Definitive Edition. And then they will fail that one as well. According to some sources, it has been rumored that GTA 4 and Red Dead Redemption remasters are very much possible. It's quite frustrating that these modders did so much work on modding a game, which is the biggest part of PC gaming, as many companies even work with the mods to make their own game better. However, in this case, Take-Two Interactive for some reason does not want to work with mods, or maybe they have, but they don't want to keep the mods working on their mods and just copy strike them instead. People have been talking about the Definitive Edition ever since the game came out, and lots of complaints on how the game looks. Model looks worse, the textures are glitching, and more importantly, the rain. It's way too bright. Well, what are you guys' thoughts about GTA Trilogy Definitive Edition as well as a possible GTA 4 remaster? What do you guys think? Let us know in the comments down below. Do you remember a game that was revealed in 2018 and never talked about ever again? Yes, that's Beyond Good and Evil 2, and looks like we finally have some news about this game. According to Tom Henderson, who has a record of leaking about games like Call of Duty and Battlefield, with most of it being true, says in Twitter that the game is suffering from development crisis from a lack of creative direction since the title went on development. It was worse when Michael Ancel left the studio in September last year. Currently, the game is not fitting Ubisoft's future ambitions and goals, which I believe would be the live service approach. The game is described as Skull and Bones 2.0, which is another game which has not been talked about ever since the gameplay reveal. According to Tom Henderson, he spoke to a couple of people in the development team, and they believe that it's a matter of time till this game is cancelled. It sucks that this game is in a state like this, because I was genuinely excited to see how Beyond Good and Evil 2 looks so amazing. Beyond Good and Evil did a fantastic job when it came out, and it was a very different game, but Beyond Good and Evil 2 looked to be absolutely different with amazing visuals. However, it's very sad to see that there is no direction right now because of how things are going with the particular development team of Beyond Good and Evil 2. The same goes with Skull and Bones, which has rumored to be restarted in terms of development process and has a new agenda. Not so sure where these games are going to go, but hopefully one day something can be done for them, and I hope that by the time that is done, these games are still relevant. Even though Rainbow Six Extraction is not out yet, Ubisoft decided to run an offer already. The game was initially planned to be released with a price tag of $60, but now it's available for $40. Ubisoft also announced that with every game purchase, you will get 2 Buddy Pass tokens that will allow your friend to download a trial version of the game that will run for 14 days. It's crazy to see how Ubisoft is making this kind of offer, not only reducing the price to $40, but also giving 2 Buddy tokens, which allows them to play a 14-day trial version of the game. That's new. Apart from that, anybody who has pre-ordered the game for $60 will now get a refund of $20. With that being said, many people do not have a positive impression on the game because it's very similar to Rainbow Six Siege, since everything just feels the same. A lot of people call this more of an expansion instead of a standalone game. The drop in the price could be possible because of Back 4 Blood, which is a zombie shooter game, and it being available in Xbox Game Pass. While Extraction is somewhat similar, but it's a slower alien shooter game. So the price drops in this case works. It has also been announced that Rainbow Six Extraction will be releasing on January 20th, 2022. So what are you guys' thoughts about Rainbow Six Extraction? Let me know in the comments below. Are you guys looking forward to play that game? I, for one, was not pleased with how the game looked. Even with the gameplay or with the trailer, I thought it could be a great DLC of how Rainbow Six Siege actually had, I thought that was good, but I don't want an extension of a game with it. In March, Assassin's Creed Valhalla narrative director Darb McDevitt announced that he'll be leaving Ubisoft to embark on a new adventure. Looks like he fell hard on that new adventure he was going on, because he's back after 9 months. Maybe he was talking about some other kind of adventure. Darb has tweeted that he pondered over his career and focused on exploring new ideas and frontiers. That made him believe that he should return to Ubisoft to work on Assassin's Creed. Nothing else was mentioned, but he did talk about the excitement to share new stories and continue the Assassin's Creed franchise. With the rumors of Assassin's Creed Infinite being a reboot to the franchise as well as it being a live service, it would be interesting to see what kind of stories will be built now that Darb is back. And again, it being live service will drastically change how Assassin's Creed always was, a single player game. Although Ubisoft's direction and ambitions are completely changing, however, I want the Assassin's Creed narration to stick to how it was. Spectacular. Well, that was the top gaming news of this very week. Hope you guys liked that one and got some information out of it. And if you did, leave a like, comment down below what do you think about any of the news we just discussed. And do not forget to subscribe to Gamer Connect to watch more news videos just like this every single week without fail.